along, let me say this is C, right? So along CD the light gets reflected, and along, so with respect to normal only I have to C irka appa idu D idu E. Names is not going to count, right? So now what happens, a part of a light gets reflected along DE and a part gets refracted inside the other medium. So let me say DE again. When the light falls on the first surface, DE fall on the first surface, there also a partially gets reflected along EF and a part of a light gets refracted along EFG, potuklama, right? Again here also, whenever the light falls on any surface, immediately will draw a normal. With respect to that only I will make the ray travel inside the other medium. Only with respect to normal only I can explain the ray is going towards the normal or away from the normal when it is traveling from rarer to denser medium or from denser to rarer medium. Right children? So here, let me say here the light ray gets refracted. Am I right children? Let angle ABN be the angle of incidence I. Right? So here angle this B N dash. So B D N dash B R. Right? So here this B L. Right? So the rays, where you will see the colored films, where you can see the colored films children, only on the surface. So the light ray which is emerging up, they only they interfere and you can see the colored films on the surface. The light which is going to travel inside the other medium, we cannot see anything under the water, is it not? So the light rays which is coming out, emerging out, that alone will interfere, forms the colored films. Right? Now what we have to find for interference, we will find out the path difference between the rays which is getting interfered. BC and EF only going to interfere, form a pattern, is it not? Right? So the path difference between these two rays, to find out what I have to do, from E I will drop a normal to BC, let it be BM. Am I right? So this is angle I and angle DEB will be angle R. This is also angle R. These two are alternate angles, so they are should be equal, right? According to mathematical, geometrical, analytical, everything, right? Now what is the path difference between the two rays BC and EF? Come on, tell me. Now when we see the path difference, the ray EF has traveled more distance inside the film, is it not children? So it is equal to BD plus DE inside the film. This is an extra path it is traveling. Ulla poyittu marubadiyum velila varu. So this is an extra path traveled, minus this extra path traveled by the ray BC outside the medium. So it is minus BM, where it is traveling in air. When you see BD and DE, can you see it is equal? BD and DE, they are equal, right? So I can write del to be equal to 2BD in film minus BM in air. Here this quantity is in air, this quantity is in film, right? So I need to change the quantity in film to the same as that in air. So what I will do, I will just multiply the quantity in film with the refractive index of the film mu, so that that term becomes BD, right? When I multiply the quantity in the film with the refractive index of that film, oil or whatever it is existing there, if I multiply with the refractive index, that quantity will be changed to the quantity in air. Maridma, so this will also be in air now, minus BM in air. Right? Now I can simplify easily, I can minus, right? You would have studied in first lesson principle of homogeneity. So both the medium should be same, only then I can do some calculation with the quantities, is it not? So I need to change this medium to that in the air. So I will just multiply it with the refractive index of the medium. Am I right children? Right. After that what you will find, I will tell you only one thing, you will find out BM alone. Wherever you see alphabets, that you reduce and find out in terms of the quantities which you see here. BM alone you will find out, finally you will get what is del. Right? So to find BM, where is BM? This is BM, I am sorry. This is angle I. Right? What is BM? BM is an opposite side to angle of incidence. So I will take sin I. Am I right, children? So sin I will give me opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite side is BM. Am I right? Hypotenuse side is B. So my BM will be equal to BE sin I. Right? Now, I know mu is equal to sin I by sin R. So from that, I will take sin I to be equal to mu sin R. So that I will substitute this here for sin I. That is mu sin R. Right? So this will be BM. I will have to find out, you will find out the alphabets existing. Enna alphabet irukku? Enna irukku? B. So you will find out that B. To find out B, what you will do, if you find out sin R, you will automatically get what is B. If you find out sin R, you will automatically get what is B. Got it, children? So to find out B only, we are finding out sin R. What is sin R? If you see R here, right? Sin R will be opposite side BL by hypotenuse side will be BD. Right? So my sin R is equal to what? BL could be written as half B. BL is half B. So for BL I will substitute half B in eldiklama by BD. And now you can find out what is B. Right? So my BE will be equal to BD sin R, and this 2 also goes to the numerator. On rearranging you will get this. So now for BE I will substitute here for BM. It's equal to, for BE it is 2 BD sin R. Put touch mu ku mu podren odane sin R ku adhe sin R ku. So on simplification we get what you will get for simple on simplification, BM is equal to 2 mu BD sin R into sin R becomes sin squared R. Right? That you will substitute here. Right? There in del. So what is del? It's equal to 2 mu BD. Already it is existing as it is. Minus for BM only we have to substitute this, which is equal to 2 mu BD. What all the quantities common? 2 is common, mu is common, that's all. Here 1 and this minus as it is, here sin squared R is existing. What is 1 minus sin squared R? Cos squared R. Now one more you have to find here, which one? BD, you have an alphabet here, right? This you will find out. To find out BD, what you will do, see where BD is existing. It is a hypotenuse side, right? We have used the opposite side. Now, we know what is a adjacent side. It is equal to the thickness. So, if I use cos R, I can find out the actual value BD, right? Because I know the adjacent side. So if I use cos R is equal to what? It's equal to DL of, that is a adjacent side, divided by the hypotenuse side is BD. Puridamma, right? What is BD? BD is equal to cos R comes to the denominator, BD goes to the numerator. So it is DL by cos R. This you will substitute here for del. Any doubt you have? So del is equal to what? It is 2 mu. For BD you will substitute DL by cos R into cos squared R. Right? Therefore 1 cos R gets cancelled. You will get 2 mu BD. Right? DL will be equal to T, the thickness of the face. film, right? So for DL I will write T into cos R. This will be the path difference between the two rays which is coming out and interfering, forming a color film on the surface of the water. Now you can see these two rays which is getting reflected on the oil surface. Oil is a denser medium when compared to air or with respect to water. Oil is a denser medium, is it not? So when any light ray getting reflected on a denser medium, it undergoes an extra path of lambda by 2. When you are walking in the air or you are walking under the water, which one you find it difficult? Why? So you have to do more work and you have to cover more path, is it not? You have to put more steps to cover at the same time. Similarly here, a ray which is getting reflected on a denser medium, it has to travel an extra path. It will travel an extra path. So that will be lambda by 2. Therefore, the actual path difference will be 2 mu t cos r. Along with that, it should have been traveled the distance lambda by 2. Got it? Right? So this will be the actual path difference. You get colored film, color avarda, that is brighter image. Next you will get a darker image. So now in interference, we are going to apply the condition for getting a bright ring. For bright ring, what is the condition? Del is equal to n lambda. So on applying this, del is equal to 2 mu t cos r plus lambda by 2 is equal to n lambda. On taking this lambda by 2 alone to that side, you will get, this has to be shifted, you will get 2n minus 1 lambda by 2 on rearranging. So 2 mu t cos r will be equal to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2 on taking lambda by 2 alone to other side. Rearrange panni paatha idu dhaan varum. So this is a condition for brightness in a thin film, right? Now for del is equal to 2 mu t cos r plus lambda by 2, for darkness what is the condition? It is 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. For darkness, this is the condition according to principle of interference. We have applied this in the Young's double slit experiment. On applying this and rearranging, bringing this lambda by 2 to the other side, you will get 2 mu t cos r is equal to n lambda. On rearranging, automatically it becomes n lambda. You want that to be shown? Right? If you want me to show, I will do it. Right? We'll take this. Shall I rub all these things or you want to take it down? No, everything is there in the book. If you want, you can do it. Right? Just a simplification we'll do. Another 2 mu t cos r plus lambda by 2 is equal to n lambda. This simplification let me do first. So 2 mu t cos r is equal to n lambda. Idanga pochana minus lambda by 2 I know. Which is common? Lambda is common. And you will have n minus r. This on rearranging, I will get 2. If I want to take common outside, I have to multiply here and divide by 2 here. So that I get 2, I have taken outside common. So I will have 2n minus 1 alone. Which one? Right? So this is for brightness. This for darkness, 2 mu t cos r plus lambda by 2 is equal to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. Right? So 2 mu t cos r, all these things let me leave it, okay? Which is equal to 2n minus 2n into lambda by 2. Let me expand it. Minus lambda by 2. This when coming on to the other side, it becomes minus lambda by 2. So plus lambda by 2, this becomes minus lambda by 2 and another one should be plus lambda by 2, is it not? Plus 1 up, podrom. No, only for the Newton's ring we used to take plus lambda. minus 1 lambda beta. Right? So on rearranging automatically you get right. Whereas the center film will be a dark one. Have you seen center will be a dark? So first poyachu. Adutha dark edukkum bodhu 2n minus 1 lambda by 2 we give the condition for the center band. Next if I take, I should take 2n plus 1 lambda by 2, is it not? So that is why we take here lambda. But here we have to consider 2n minus 1 lambda by 2 down. Right? So on rearranging only, so if this becomes plus means both this gets cancelled and you will get only these two also gets cancelled. You will have only n lambda remaining. Okay? Clear children? Whereas in Young's double slit experiment, we have the central band to be bright. So we take the condition, the darker one to be 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. Whereas in interference of thin films, the center will be dark. Since the center is dark, we have to apply the condition there for the central ring to be 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. So next to apply pannumbod enna pannano 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 apply. Right, that is why we take 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 and this we will follow for the Newton's ring. Next one also. Got it children? This is an important, very very important 10 mark question. Now when we consider these two rays which are coming out, which is coming out inside the film, they get refracted and interfere, form a pattern under the water. For that, if the interference takes place, the path difference is equal to 2 mu t cos r is equal to what? It's equal to n lambda for brightness, the same as that of the Young's double slit, and this will be equal to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2 for the darkness. Why? Because it is not getting reflected at the denser medium, it is getting refracted. So any ray which is getting reflected from the denser medium alone will travel an extra path of lambda by 2 and it undergoes a phase change of pi. Corresponding phase change will be pi, illaya? Lambda path difference lambda by 2 na adanoda corresponding phase enna irukum? Pi thane? Correct ah na solradhu? Right. So this is the interference of thin film. Next one is a Newton's ring experiment. This Newton's ring experiment is an experiment which has been done in the lab so that we get a ring like a pattern which is formed outside, that is a colored pattern that we can produce in the lab, that is called as a Newton's ring. For producing the Newton's ring, that is also due to the interference of thin film. For that we need an experimental setup. That experimental setup has a, we have to take a plano-convex lens. A plano-convex lens of very large radius of curvature, right? And it has to be placed on a glass plate. It has to be placed on a glass plate. This is an experimental setup and therefore it forms a thin air film. Can you see? Right? And it is descending towards the center. Descending na koranjikitte varudha. Center ku poga poga koranjikitte varudhu. So we are producing a thin air film by taking a plano-convex lens, placing it on the plain glass plate. Right? Now, a source of light which is going to be focused on a, or it is made to fall on a diverging lens, made it as a parallel beam, then falls on a glass plate which is kept at 45 degree with respect to the angle of incidence. Right? So it falls on the glass plate at 45 degree in such a way the glass plate has been placed. So the ray gets partially reflected inside the lens and therefore when you see the ray, two films is formed, right? Two layers of the air film has been formed. One ray, it gets reflected on the top surface of the air film. Other ray partially reflects from the top surface. And other ray, it may penetrate inside the air film, reaches the glass plate and there it may get reflected. These two reflected rays from the top and the bottom surface of the air film. This is a top surface. This is a bottom surface, that is a glass plate. In these two surfaces, it is going to reflect and after it gets reflected, they interfere and forms a pattern that could be viewed through the spectrometer or through the vernier microscope. Right? So this is the experimental setup for the Newton's ring experiment. Now, for Newton's ring experiment, we need to do a theory, right? what is the path difference between the two rays getting reflected from the upper and the lower surface of the air film? It is going to travel inside. The extra path traveled by the second ray will be, it is traveling inside the air film through a distance t. Again it will travel the same distance through the distance t. So 2t will be the path difference between the ray which is getting reflected, which is getting reflected on the upper and the lower surface of the air film. Have you got this, children? Right? So 2t will be the path difference. And again you can see the second ray getting reflected from on the glass plate. Glass plate is a denser or rarer medium? Denser when compared to air. So an extra path will be travelled by the reflected ray, and for the brightness the condition is n lambda. When you rearrange you will get 2t will be equal to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2, what we have simplified and I showed you. Right? So the path difference will be 2t plus lambda by 2, which is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 for darkness. So on rearranging we get 2t is equal to n lambda for darkness. Right? The central band will be the dark band. Just have you got this, children? Now in Newton's ring experiment, the central ring, normally in interference the central ring will be bright, whereas here in Newton's ring experiment or the interference of thin film, the central ring is dark. The central bright ring is dark. Why? When the rays which are striking at the central point, you can see one ray getting reflected on the curved surface of the plano convex lens. Other ray will penetrate inside the glass plate, and on the glass plate it gets reflected. So these two rays, one ray getting reflected on the curved surface of the plano convex lens, second ray getting reflected on the glass plate. This second ray is traveling an extra path of lambda by 2 because it is getting reflected from a denser medium. So these two rays, when they interfere, what happens? They are out of phase with each other. A extra phase of pi had happened in the second ray, right? They are not in phase with each other, they are out of phase with each other. Any two rays which are out of phase with each other interfere, they produce a darkness. Two rays which are in phase with each other, they produces a brightness. Crest crest produces brightness, trough trough produces a brightness. These two rays are in phase, whereas one crest, one trough, they are out of phase. So out of phase with respect to each other, they produces a darkness. The same is adopted here. One ray, this is a very very important 3-mark question. Why the in Newton's ring experiment the central ring is dark? Why the central ring is dark? When you draw and see, one ray getting reflected on the curved surface, other ray getting reflected from the glass plate. So the second ray which is getting reflected from the glass plate, you can name the rays, right? So that it will be easy for you to remember. Second ray getting reflected from the glass plate, glass is a denser medium, so it undergoes an extra phase of pi or path of lambda by 2. So these two rays which are interfering, they are out of phase with each other. That is why they produce darkness at the center point. Everything has been given in this on the next page. In a page number 189 la irukku paaru, mele the thickness of the film irka, and the padichinga na you will understand. Have you understood why the central ring is dark? Right.